today we'll talk about how to use candlesticks in your trading. So here we go. Good morning, traders. Welcome back to Puerto Vallarta. I got kicked out of my room because they're doing the cleaning now, so I'm gonna try to find a place to get some coffee and work. It's a little bit late for my standards, like already 10 p.m. and I've been working the whole morning, so enjoying the view on the beach now a little bit, getting downstairs for coffee, and we'll get started with that day. So first, I'll share with you a mindset shift when it comes to candlesticks, something that you have to flip and think about it kind of a different way. Then we'll talk about what I consider to be the best candlestick patterns, and I'm going to shoot an example of trade with that. And finally, we'll go through the best things about candlestick, how you can use them, and the cool thing with that, basically. And that's pretty much the reason why you should use them in your trading. But first, let's go in the beginning. I want to share with you the mindset shift, the problem people have with candlestick. Well, I had to change location because of the noise, but we're back in my room. Now, here's the mindset people have wrong with candlestick, basically, overall. And people tend to kind of want to classify everything. They hear, you need to learn candlestick pattern. Well, this is that, that's the name, that's a doji, that's a hammer, that's a morning star, that's whatever. And I think that's fine in the beginning, but then you don't want to be stuck on classifying those names because it's not necessarily right. And you might find out that candlestick patterns have particularities that work well for your strategy, and you kind of use a combination of all of them. But it's going to be up to you to define your own rules based on that. And even though you might find a book on candlestick patterns that explain exactly what the candlestick is, what the pattern is, it might vary between people and between traders and authors. Some people say this is an all thing, people say this is not an all thing, you need this and that. And so you want to be able to define your own rules based on what you've seen work. And more on that later. Now, I promise I would give you guys my favorite candlestick pattern. I trade kind of a mix of engulfing candles and other things. And this is a mistake people make sometimes also. Is they don't really understand that candlestick pattern has to be used with other things. You would read a book, for example, the book Japanese Candlestick Charting Techniques by Steve Nyson. A really good book, highly recommend. But at the end of the book, it's talking about how to use this in combination to other things. It's not like a pure science to use by itself. There's other parts you need to put in place. And there's kind of a process you need to respect to get to a profitable trade or a profitable strategy, because that's really important also. I use what we call the engulfing pattern. I've done a whole lot of videos and blog posts on that before into like what I consider to be a candlestick pattern. Some are better than others in terms of these engulfing candles. Some rules tend to make it more reliable than others. For example, I've seen that one price breaks the high of the previous candlestick, it's more reliable than just breaking the open or the close of the previous candlestick. That's a small difference. And then if it goes beyond the low, for example, when you buy, when it's a bullish shingle, so it goes beyond the low and above the high, also better, but that happens very rarely. So if you were to trade only that, it might be difficult. Without the hint too complicated, the reason why I like this candlestick pattern so much is mainly because it kind of gives a clear indication that the trend reverse. Technically, the highs and the lows of a day or a period can be important. And when you see a shift, it means like there's a bigger pressure now than the previous candlesticks, meaning that price might reverse in the opposite direction because there's more pressure from the opposite party, like the buyers, the sellers, whatever. So I want to show you guys an example of that and go through the process that I follow all the time. Very similar to what I've talked about before, but let's go on the chart. Here we are on AODCAD. I want to guide you guys through what happens. So first thing first is during the weekend, like we're now, well, not going to be Monday for you, but for me it's a weekend. I go through the charts and I look at the zones where price might reverse in the future, okay, the zones that are upcoming. So every cat, there was a zone at 0.94, and what you see is price reversed in the past, so you put the line over here, it reversed many times in the past at this level. So I was watching price when it got to that level. Now look at this on low time frame. I trade these on low time frame, of course. Look at what happened in the 4-hour chart. So price got to the zone, I'll just go back. Went from 0.97 down, up, and down, up and down, crossed the level here. And then just near there, not too far, it's not even, well, about 100 pips from that level. Keep in mind these are zones, so really important to think about. Price made this engulfing candle. Okay, and what's particular about this one is that this one where it was outside the bone Japan. Now, the thing about this one here, this was a gap, I believe. Not good, I don't trade that. But here, it's a different pattern. So this is an engulfing candle. It doesn't go below the low, as you see on the chart. But for me, that's a good engulfing candle. Okay, that's totally fine. That's not perfect, but that's fine. And it closes above the high of the candlestick. Not above the open of the candlestick here, but above the high. Always much better. What I do with this is I combine it with the Bongjuban. I like to use more tools for confluence. Bongjuban for me is something that fits well with that, I believe. So I see that price breaks outside the Bongjuban, even closest below the Bongjuban. And we did a video on that a few weeks back. I'll put it below on why that makes sense and why this is a good way to trade. So from there, I enter above the high, stop loss below the low, and then you decide on your exit strategy. For me, it's always the same. I was at 1-to-1 and 2-to-1 with regard to risk. For you, that could be different. You decide. Okay, so 1-to-1 would be around here, and 3-to-1 would be a little bit lower than that, and 3-to-1 would be around here, I believe. Okay, so that's how this works. And of course, if you expect, like we talk about, a move on the weekly chart, like where the support area, we expect at least price to go somewhere here. Well, this is kind of a small target, okay, on the forward chart. This is kind of 0.945, and we expect that price might reverse all the way to 0.96, okay, or close to that. So that's a pretty good target, pretty conservative in my opinion. And that's how these trades unfold. Now, that being explained, what makes the candlestick so useful in trading? Well, first thing first is that you have a lot of possibility to kind of customize and tweak it to your own rules. Like, if you want to make something better, or you want to find a way for your strategy to take more trades, add candlestick patterns, add different variations, and test them if they work. They might not work, they might work really well, but the cool thing is that you can define your own rules. And from there, you say, well, this candlestick pattern works well with those rules. How about if I do this, and I tweak it a little bit, and I add something new? How about if we go from engulfing candle to hammer? In my experience, that works not that good. Or what if we go from engulfing to doji? Again, not that good. But what if we think about piercing line? So those candlestick with kind of a gap. Or dark cloud cover, okay? Which are names that you don't have to think about necessarily. But what if we tweak it a little bit and try something new to kind of add more room? And then you test. It's always about testing your ideas. Trying something out, testing it. But you have a lot of options of things you can do and try and apply if they work well. So that's the big thing. Like, you cannot do this sometimes with indicators. It's kind of fixed, it's a rule. When it's this, it means it's a trade setup. When it's not, it's not. But candlestick pattern can be customized and can be adjusted to whatever you want. So a lot of option there. And that's part of all this beautiful thing. So I hope that makes sense, guys. And I didn't go through the pairs yet, but you guys let me know down below in the comment if you want me to go through the pairs. I might do this, I might not, in a future video. I think this was not super requested from you guys, but I'm happy to do it if needed. And if not, we'll just skip that. But I'm going through the pair and I'm finding the level as always. Comment below this video if you have anything you look forward to this week, any trading thing you have or any goal you have or anything you just want to crush and make happen. Comment below for sure. Give it a like if you enjoyed this video as always, and I'll catch you guys back here tomorrow in Puerto Vallarta for another video. Ciao.